guys, welcome to my channel and thank you for stopping by. Today I will take a closer look at one of my truck kits, and that is on a request from Stefan Olsson, who would like to take a closer look at that one. I was thinking about doing an unboxing of that kit anyway, so of course when Stefan he asked me to, the choice was easy. So it is Ertl's or Ertl, or however you choose to pronounce it, is their Volvo N-10. It's that model truck you can see, or model of truck you can see on this picture. In my personal opinion, it's always been one of Volvo's most beautiful trucks, I think. I always like the N-10 really, really much. I actually built it as a boy many years ago, as a kid. You can see the model here, and unfortunately, I sold that one at one point, the model, to a guy who wanted to do some casting of the cabin and the nose of the truck. But I never heard from him again, so I don't know how that went. But anyway, since then I was lucky enough to get hold on a couple of these Volvo kits, and I'm going to unbox one of them today. So just a second. Okay, here are the kit, if you don't already know which one I'm talking about. Ertl Volvo NT, and of course in 1:25 scale, and they made this one also in 1:32 scale, 32nd scale, and the box actually looks a lot like this one. So if you manage to find one online, be sure that you have the right scale, that you don't think you bought a 1:25 and then suddenly you receive a 1:32 scale kit. That will not be very nice. So yeah, so be sure of that. I can actually not see anywhere on the box or on the instructions any year for this kit, but I will try and find out. And if I find the kit, or rather if I find out what year it was issued, I will put it on the video here. So but let's unbox the kit and see what's inside. First of all, we have the instructions, and I think they're actually quite, you know, quite like something we've seen before. Not any specifics about the instructions. They have a lot of different languages. That's nice. So, not so much to say about the instructions. They're nice and informative. So that's the most important. The decals. Yeah, silver, black, and white. One piece stripings, and you have some license plates. You have some from the states, Iowa, Illinois, Texas, and then Victoria Garden State, I guess that's Australia. And then it says European, but that's actually Swedish license plates, except that Swedish license plates, they're not silver colored, they should be white. But and I think my Swedish friends must excuse me, I think they are white also for trucks, if I remember correct. And then a little black decal for the hood. So not so much on the decal sheet here, but yeah, if you want to use these stripes, they're there. Then we have the chrome. You can see here the smokestack is in one piece, and there's only one smokestack on this truck. It have some nice wheels. Here are the grill. Very nice castings. The engine. dashboard, engine parts here, the seats, and the interior bucketed. Actually, a very nice casting, you know, with like rubber mats casted on the floor. And the seats are quite nice also. So it looks very good. Another chrome tree here. The rear fenders, US style. There's the, what do you call that? Kangaroo bar. That's what we call it in Danish, translated to English. Mirrors. Also something that looks like American style. I cannot remember if these are original Volvo mirrors, but they probably are. It's many years ago we saw this kind of Volvo on the Danish roads, so I don't remember how the mirrors look like. You've got the air horns, handles, different small parts, turbo, oil pan. But very nice casting and very nice chrome actually. It looks very good. Then you have some black parts, and one thing that is actually nice with this kit, I think, is that I will show you here. You have the choice between single headlights and double headlights, and if I remember correct, the double headlights are the US style, and the single headlights is the European style. Else, you have the some engine parts, seat bases, and here more engine parts, drive shaft, looks like some tank, brake parts, battery parts. And here you have the rear springs, the inner wheels, brake plates, holders for the tanks, fuel tanks, the fender, rear fenders, what do you call that, mud guards you call it, I guess. And then one thing that is very special for this kit, and I know Ertl made one or two other kits with the same feature, and that is that the frame is actually metal. And you can see the front springs are molded in the frame, and that's actually a thing that annoys me a little bit, because as I mentioned, I have two of this kit, and one of them I wanted to build maybe as a dump truck or something like that. So I have to extend the frame, and well, let me just say it's more easy if you have a plastic frame than a metal frame. But anyway, I have a complete plastic frame from another truck kit that I'm not going to use, so I can make something out of that. But it's a little annoying, I think. And actually also the rear axles and a lot of small parts are metal. As you can see here, the fifth wheel are metal. Front axle, and then you have some small parts. I cannot really see what that is, but so you have quite a lot of metal parts in the kit. But that's the way it is. The tires, they're quite nice, and they are Goodyears. I don't know if you can see the thread pattern on this one, but nice hollow tires. They look actually fine. The glass, one piece, front window, rear window, side windows, all in there, and as a one piece. So that makes it a lot easier, I think, than individual windows. So that's nice. And then we have the parts that I guess most of you are waiting for. The cabin and the front, and there's also some front fenders coming out. But here you see a and it's actually a perfect fit. And that's how it's going to look. A little difficult to see maybe, but yeah. It's very, very nice casting, I think. The cabin being one piece with nice details. The firewall is also molded with the cabin, so that makes it very easy to paint. You don't have to paint it and put the interior and then put together a cab around the interior, so this one is much easier. And also the front end is of course one piece, and there you have the Volvo letters here, and they're quite distinct, so it should be no problem painting them after you painted the hood. So there you have it, guys. That is the Volvo N10 truck from Ertl, and it's a very nice kit, and I can only recommend that if you get the chance, you buy one. Of course, the metal frame is a little different to work with this kit than the normal plastic kits, but most of the kit is of course plastic, as you can see, but it can be done. When I was a kid and I built mine, it was of course also with the metal frame, and there was no problem for me to put it together, so it should be no problem, but you just have to be prepared for all the metal parts, and then there should be no problem. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this little unboxing. And if you have any suggestions to future videos, or if you have any of my models in my stash that you would like to take a closer look at, please go in the comments under this video and mention, or go to our Facebook group called Kip's Custom Garage. In there, you can also put your suggestions for future videos or whatever, and don't be shy. If there's anything you'd like to take a closer look at, let me know. And please subscribe to my channel. I really need the last subscribers so I can reach 1,000 and then go on from there. So please subscribe to my channel. It's only one click, no problem for you, and it's free. And I hope you enjoyed this video, guys, and I will see you in my next one. Bye-bye.